welcome to Along the Lines. Today, again, we're out. In fact, we're heading on a week-long adventure. We are heading to Fairford Air Show, which is happening over the weekend that's coming. It's now Monday morning. We've got a full car, fully packed, and we're heading to pick up our camper van that we'll be taking for the whole week. Our packing was just fantastic. We've got the beer, we've got the wine, we've got the underpants, and of course I've got my knitting. So I think we're sorted. Where's the doo-doo-doo?
Guys, one turn.
Please wait while your call is connected.
Jessica, good morning.
Hiya, we're here to pick up our camper. So, the outside's easy.
We'll
do the outside first.
Yeah, cool.
All anyway.
Yeah, for sure.
So is this Andrew's bedroom?
Yeah, that's my bedroom, yeah.
Before we put all of our stuff, let me quickly show you around. So we've got the kitchen. We've got the oven and fridge. We have the bathroom with a toilet and a lovely shower. Look at that sink. That sink's nicer than the one I've got at home. And then finally, there's a bedroom at the end with an infinite amount of storage all around. So now we need to bring the car closer and move all of our stuff in, and then we'll sit and go. Now here's a tip from the pros. Before we hit the road, I am putting just a layer of kitchen roll between each one, and then they won't rattle like crazy while we're driving. It makes so much difference. And you get there feeling so much more refreshed. And we're good. I've put the essentials in the fridge for when we get there, so we can have a bottle of bubbly, and I'll stock the fridge once we get there and it's cooled down. And this is why I wanted to show you before we started putting our stuff in. This is the shower. It's full of stuff, and everywhere is full of stuff until we start making use of the awesome storage that's absolutely everywhere around the camper. So, I think we're ready to hit the road and head to our campsite for the week. There's something quite special about the camper van experience in that everything rattles. We've organized things as best as we can for now, but it's inevitable. There'll be some rattle or some honking around and you're not quite sure where it is, but it shouldn't be too long before we get there and we can get really settled in and comfortable and good for the week. A lot of weird sounds happening back there. Let's hope everything's still in one piece when we get there. I usually very much approve of roundabouts, which are kind of the UK's alternative to four-way stops and stop signs everywhere. However, we're going through Milton Keynes at the moment. Milton Keynes is basically the city of roundabouts. It was a designed city where they tried to create a new system. So the roads we were going down were all, we were going down H8, so horizontal 8, and we were crossing all the verticals, V1, V2, V3, V4, and with each one of those hitting a roundabout. And when you're in a camper with cutlery and crockery and stuff everywhere, It's a little bit challenging, but we're nearly done with Milton Keynes. The next big city we're going to go through is going to be Oxford. And I believe we have now left Milton Keynes. Thank you for visiting Milton Keynes. Bye-bye. We're following another Just Go caravan. I wonder where they're going. You're good.
Please stop. Okay.
That's the wonkiest stop sign ever.
Doing a bit. So which way should I go? Should I just go along?
I guess so, yeah.
And then we can work it out.
We're now settling in and we've found our spot and I'm unpacking all the food and now comes an essential part of the trip. We start with a good glass of wine. This morning's been a great relaxing start. We made some egg McMuffins on the barbecue and we're just enjoying watching the first few planes arrive. We've had an F-35 and now it's just a lovely sunny afternoon, just chilling out. And of course I've got my beer and my knitting. I'm working on some hedgehog fibers, plain vanilla socks. Just something nice and easy. So this is our setup. We've got our shelter for the sun or for the rain, but hopefully, fingers crossed, this year we shouldn't have any rain. And we've got a little windbreak to just keep the breeze off of our sight. And then behind we've got our camper. And then we set up another little tiny shelter, which I'm gonna call my napping shelter. And it appears that our tent has become the dragonfly mating season ritual place. There's one there. Where are the other ones? Two more over here. The other ones have gone.
Buy me these, please. Yes. I've been fancying these for ages. I just completely forgot that I fancied them.
It's good when that happens, isn't it?
Yeah, I know. Yummy.
I want chocolate. What do I want?
I might go for a tube of Rolos.
Oh yeah. Do you want any games?
Will it keep you busy?
Probably not. Oh, you want
do
night?
You, you do have a freezer. We'll come back another day for us.
Yeah, okay.
Still got stuff.
That's £1.90 then, please.
Hold that. Okay. Grab the money out of the backpack.
Where is it?
In the end pocket, the little one.
So I feel like a kid. Pay the money and then gonna have the change, please.
Thanks very much. Thank you.
Have a good day. Right in the correct bit. It was like it was made to me.
What are you doing?
I'm trying to get it shut. Right, let's go.
So we... Am I recording? Yeah. So we went for beer at the tent, and we just stopped by Ella's shop to pick up some chocolate, because we can, because we're on holiday. And you've just got to see quite how close the campsite is to the air show. So there you go, that's the fence that goes straight to the air show. Medic tent? Chocolate overdose? So there's not much over there right now, but that's going to be full with all the static display planes in the next few days as they start arriving. But for now, I think we'll go back to our campsite, chill out a bit more. This field becomes a campsite for this one week of the year, but something tells me it must be a sheep field the rest of the time, because I've spotted these. So that looks like it's all bits of sheep fleeces. I know there's a name for those, but it's just a fleece that gets cut all along as the sheep kind of get a little bit too close to the fence. So yeah, I guess the rest of the year, this field, rather than being filled with campers, must be filled with sheep. Taking advantage of a slight lull in the noise between all the jets coming past to fill you in. So it's now Wednesday afternoon and we've been having a wonderfully quiet morning. Oh, there goes a jet again. As I was saying, it's been a fairly relaxed start to the day and we've just been chilling out. We've gone for our showers at the campsite showers. I don't know if you can even hear me. So being Wednesday, people are really starting to fill up the campsite. We've got some new lovely neighbors and all the planes are starting to arrive. So the kind of front line from which we can see from the campsite is also starting to fill up. It's really interesting. You start seeing air forces from numerous countries around the world. While in normal conditions, I often feel like my camera's a little bit overkill, here I'll have, I guarantee you, one of the smallest cameras and one of the smallest lenses around. So this gives you a pretty good idea of what the activities and the conversations will be like this weekend. They'll be kind of stilted, split conversations as we all stop and go silent while one of our favorite planes goes past. One of the brilliant things about events like this is the sense of camaraderie and kind of immediate friendship that you develop with everyone who's staying nearby. Andrew's currently giving a tour of the camper, I think it's the third one today, to somebody who's staying nearby, because everyone's got a different setup. Everyone arrives every year with kind of slight tweaks to how they organize themselves. So every year we've been making a better list of what to bring and what not to bring, so that you've just got the perfect setup for the week. We're lucky this year with good weather, but we're still prepared. We've got everything. We've got our wellies. We've got lots of cleaning stuff to make do if it were to be a really muddy year. And it's just great seeing all the tents and all of the campers and everyone's little, almost little village pop up. Some have been coming for almost as long as I've been alive. So we were chatting with some people who've been coming since the 80s and who are telling us how much it's changed. And they come with family, they come with their parents. It's just fantastic. We've been hunting down the ice cream van. I'll have the ice cream van tune stuck in my head for the next week, guaranteed. And there's still some evening arrivals, so some of the planes, some of the helicopters, lots of setting up still going on. And from the air show starts on Friday, we're now Wednesday, but from tomorrow there'll be a lot more arrivals. It's been awesome watching the planes come in, but if there's one thing, planes do not wait until you finish knitting your row. So every so often I've had to just chuck the socks I've been working on and hope I can find where I'm at and which row I'm doing and what I'm up to, because I just wanted to be able to just stand up, grab the camera and go check out the planes. Over the course of the week, that's why I've decided that I'm only bringing simple projects, easy things to work on. I'm currently turning the heel on my gorgeous blue Fiji socks, and I want to have the heels completely turned before we go into the air show on Friday, so I can go back to just knitting vanilla sock, just the foot length, while we're in there. That way I have to pay absolutely no attention to my knitting, but I can still have it with me. Perfect. It's gone quiet on the plane front, so we're now having dinner. We're having some steak burgers with pineapple rings, cheddar, a little chutney, and Andrew's got some asparagus and a pepper roasting on the barbecue. So if anyone tells you that you can't eat well when you're camping, that's a lie. With a barbecue, you can do just about anything. Oh, and of course, we've got a glass of Prosecco. Barbecued asparagus is so delicious. And here's a camping tip. There's obviously little bugs up in the top of the awning, so I've hidden our little salsa under a kitchen roll so we don't get bugs as an additional source of protein. Tomato and apricot chutney, cheddar, Welsh steak burger, pineapple rings, and a balsamic toasted bun with some roasted peppers. I think we've got this figured out. Cheers! Thursday morning, day 4 of our stay at the campsite, and it's been a lovely, relaxing morning. More knitting. Sock update. Heel flap done. Next, heel turn. It's now Thursday night, and we can see along the runway there's still all the people beavering away in preparation. The air show starts tomorrow. One thing that's really blown me away this week, and that's really making me appreciate technology as we know it, is the fact that I have been able to not only get my work done, So it's taken me a few hours a day to just keep on top of email support, make sure all our users are happy, everything's going smoothly. But I've also managed, if you've watched episode 27, so last week's episode, I uploaded that on Tuesday night, I edited it on my laptop, and I uploaded it entirely from this camper van. So it's just amazing to think that we now have good enough mobile data on our phones that we're able to just do all of that away from the old school internet connections at home. Sorry, I'm getting distracted because somebody's watching me talk to myself. So as I said, Thursday night, it's been great so far. We've had our work done, I've had my video done, and sock update. I've now turned the heel and I'm now onto the gusset. My aim is to finish that. Ooh, we're Thursday, tomorrow's the air show. Ah, so I might try and finish that tonight so that I can be just onto the foot tomorrow, so I can just go nicely in the round with nothing else to think about. But first, our little fridge, fairly big fridge for a campervan fridge, is now pretty much out of stock. So we're going to the beer and food tent for dinner tonight, and tomorrow Andrew's parents are joining us. They're coming with food and drink supplies, and they're joining us for the weekend for the air show. I'm really looking forward to things kicking off for real, but for now, I think that's it for today. Off for drink. It's Friday morning, it's time to finally head in for the air show. We've got slightly cloudy weather, but I think it's gonna be a good day with lots of planes. Ready? Let's go! So there's the fence. That theoretically goes straight into the air show, but unfortunately that's not the way in for normal attendees. So we're heading instead that way.
Can you just put your bag on the floor and sort of empty everything from it, I guess?
Oh my god, really?
Thank you. Cool, have a nice day.
You too, thank you.
Put the camera in too?
Yes, please.
Yeah.
Did you pick your camera up?
Yep. That sign looks oddly like a flip-up name. As Andrew pointed out, it says Royal Air Force Bomb Disposal, but what does it say when they flip the screen? I want to know, is it Royal Air Force Ice Cream Van? When I was a kid, the only air shows that I remember going to in Canada were the seeing the snowbirds do their acrobatics, and the British team, the Red Arrows, whose planes you can see there, were have just been my absolute favourite since I've moved to the UK. It's a team of nine, and they are just so precise and perfect. It's just amazing to watch.
The fact that Boris Serret, giving a brilliant demonstration in previous years on one of the small French aircraft, had requested that he be allowed to take off and land on the ski jump. None of us doubted that he could do it, but it was just too late. There was no room to get him into practice as the rules provided. And so one of the most wonderful shows that Barbara never took place.
So they were running short on pilots, so I thought I'd step in and lend a hand. Now, where's the go button? We're taking a break from the breeze, and we've come into what's always a highlight of my trip to the air show, is coming to the vintage village. It's so lovely. There's all sorts of stuff to buy, so it's a little market. There's tea and scones, and every few hours there's also little dance demonstrations, which are always so adorable.
taxi, I'm heavy deep. Call me a taxi, I get out of the way. If I don't get there, my name is Sid.
I wonder if they make these in my size. So this is the latest in our military arsenal. It's very easy to transport. You simply deflate it, take it to destination, and then reinflate it. And I assure you, it's as good as the real thing. Johnny Five is alive! And he might be the one making the ice cream.
With 24, 30 and 47 squadrons operating the C-130J. Squadron with the A400M, as you see in front here. Obviously this one is an industry version.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the right, the Raptors slow.
When she's not vlogging at the air show.
The large number of RAF officers served on exchange and loan service with the Sultan. You've mentioned solar distancing is the only team in the world performing fully aerobatic maneuvers with an effective
helicopter. The air show used to be cheap burgers, cheap sausages. Looks like they've really upped their game. Pulled pork burger for lunch. Not quite sure how to attack it though.
The aircraft reach a height of 7,000 feet. On top, the fabulous red smoke. As the synchro pair get ready, draw a heart, ladies and gentlemen. Keep your eyes top right on the heart. You'll see a third jet. This is going to be Red 9. He's going to draw the final touch and add a spear to the heart. Well, this year, the Air Training Corps is celebrating its 75th anniversary. So, the Red Arrows would like to dedicate this heart to all of the air cadets, all of the volunteer reserve training officers in the Air Cadet organisation, and also to the civilian instructors. As we get ready for a very patriotic moment, and the juice!
Yeah, we've got all the green. Yeah.
Red, white, and blues have a huge patriotic round of applause, ladies and gentlemen!
That's a ruddy hell video right there.
these strange people who've settled in our camp. Do you know what I said? They're going to come and say, look, they've taken over. We're back from the air show and we've adopted two strangers. It's Andrew's mum and dad who are joining us for the weekend. And seeing as today's our wedding anniversary, we're having a little bit of bubbly. Seems to be a theme here this week.
Congratulations, you two.
Now let's have pints of Prosecco. So, last year, it was a bit chilly and Andrew's mum, Kathy, got a little bit cold on the day that we went into the air show. And this year she decided to remedy that situation, so I think she should be okay for tomorrow. Perfect. Andrew's now got the barbecue going and we'll be having some steaks, some jacket potatoes. Here's another plate. In short, I think we've got the perfect holiday. Not the perfect hairdo, but the perfect holiday for sure.
Can I just say I'm not the only one listening to Andrew Murray?
Oh no, I can hear it everywhere. It's like an echo everywhere, isn't
it? How's this for a nice setup? So, we're watching the tennis, Roy's preparing our starter, Andrew's pouring the wine.
And I'm being a nuisance.
On the first day when we arrived, I was trying to quickly catch a couple of photos of some of the planes that were coming in, and I didn't have any pockets, and my dress doesn't have any pockets, so I put it in the only logical place I could. There, which very much amused our campsite neighbor. You make do with what you've got. Skipping on to day two of the air show, we're heading over like little packed mules. And we're going to watch the show, have a picnic, and just have a lovely, relaxing time. It's been a mass exodus from the campsite as everyone is heading into the show. We can see kind of people starting to crowd around. The staff's hard at work keeping the campsite gorgeous and clean, and we're off to have some fun. The Saturday show is now in full swing. We've had already some of the jets and we've just had the Italians doing their aerobatics. And I always love seeing them. They're so cheerful, they're so bubbly and excited. And today we've come in and we pretty much did the polar opposite of what we did yesterday. Yesterday we came with two tiny bags, the bare minimum. This time we have built a veritable tent city. The Italians are going past again. So we've got a whole setup, we've got a full picnic, and I think it should be quite nice and cozy today. Knitting update, I'm now on the instep decreases, and I'm not sure I'll have the socks done by the end of the weekend, but progress, nice, relaxing day. Now this is one of my absolute favourites. It's the Chinook, and just have a look at how capable an aircraft it is. But also towards the end, have a look at the guy who's waving from the very back of the open door. mid-afternoon ice cream break. Don't mind if I do.
You nearly pushed it against the screen.
What could possibly possess someone to want to be a wing walker? Crazy lady! So yesterday I mentioned that some of the food here at the air show has just been very different to the old average burger and sausage that we've been getting in previous years. And the one that really caught my attention is Martin's Smoker. So you said this is your first year.
Yeah, this is our first year doing outside trading. We've got a restaurant already.
Whereabouts?
So in Oxford, we've got the Oxford Blue Smokehouse.
Excellent.
And then we've decided to sort of stretch out and do outside catering now, so doing festivals and things like that. So, yeah.
So we are picking up. It's interesting trying to do interviews when you've got jets shooting past behind.
Next year we'll be pushing for more festivals, so hopefully we'll get back to Isle of Wight and we'll go to Common People again, and hopefully we'll try for Southampton.
Excellent, so we'll be heading back, assuming that my father-in-law Roy hasn't eaten all of them, we'll be heading back to camp with, yesterday we had some pulled pork burgers, and we'll be taking probably some pork ribs and a few bits like that. And I hear that you make your own barbecue sauce as well?
We do make our own barbecue sauce.
So if you enjoy good barbecue food, do keep an eye for the really cool smoker. And Old Smoky Barbecue. Thanks, Martin.
That's all right,
no
worries.
Have a good weekend.
Yeah, thank you. Cheers. It's been good. Cheers, thank you. Absolutely beautiful. But the food has been brilliant. Hospitality, company, aircraft, fantastic. Yay!
Hardworking police officers need ice cream too, don't they? So we're all a bit windswept, all a little bit tired, and it's time to head home after a really, really good day of air show. Day of the air show's in full swing. Everyone in there is having a lovely time. The clouds are starting to rise, so there should be plenty of great stuff happening in the show. In the meantime, well, we're having an epic breakfast. Andrew's making bacon rashers on the barbecue, and we've got eggs, beans, toast, the lot. And then later on, we might go for a little potter back in the show. But for now, nice chilled out morning. And of course, socks update. I'm now onto the straight part of the foot and making my way towards the toes. Getting there. What better way to finish the weekend of the air show than with a gorgeous rainbow? It was an absolutely fantastic weekend. We had so much fun. It's now Sunday evening and everyone's heading home. The planes are going home and we're here for one last night. As you can see, we've put our gazebo away now. So it's just one more night and tomorrow morning, very early start in order to return the camper back to its base, back to the company we borrowed it from. And then we go home and back to reality. And then next week, back to the craft room. I've got so much cool stuff to show you. I cannot wait to do some crafty stuff again. And I will see you next week. Bye bye.
No rule to get him into practice is the rules provided. And so one of the most wonderful shows of Barbara never took place.
after last night's goodbyes and seeming all straightforward, it just looked like it was going to be a clean cut, you know. Put stuff away and get the camper out and off we go. But never quite so simple. We are stuck in the mud and we've now got a pickup truck that's going to try and get us out. We even had half the campsite helping us push with all their strong muscle, but clearly it's going to take more than that. And of course, in the meantime, we get to watch and hear all the airplanes leaving. Wow.